So OnePlus 7 Pro officially launched today, and as expected, all the tech YouTubers have flooded YouTube with OnePlus 7 Pro reviews. So I don't want to bore you guys with another review. So instead of a review, what I want to do is I want to talk about the design choices that the company OnePlus has made with this phone, and we will try to analyze the pros and cons of those design choices, whether these design choices are actually meant for the consumers, you know, for people like you and me, or these design choices, they are actually for the bottom line of the company. So a more fundamental question is, why is OnePlus using a all screen display? Why do we need it, right? Why did this race start for completely eliminating bezels? So if you look at the history of phones, you have to go back all the way to Samsung Galaxy Note series. So that was the phone which was sporting a 5.3 inch display. Now 5.3 doesn't sound like a, you know, a big screen, but back in 2011, I mean, in the smartphone era, that's like an eternity. And this phone, because it had a 5.3 inch screen, which was back then, everybody was saying that this is ridiculous. This is like a ginormous screen. Why do you need 5.3 inch screen on a phone? But all those critics were, you know, turned out to be wrong, because people loved this phone and it became a surprise hit. So if you remember that phone also, in fact, all the phones from that time, they used to have big bezels. So the top bezel, the bottom bezel, and the bezels on the side, they used to be big. It was not a problem because the screen size was small for all the other phones. Remember the iPhone that Apple used to sell at that time with tiny screen and, you know, a huge chin and a huge forehead and side bezels. So that was the design language. And it worked fine because the screen was small. But when Samsung started selling these phones with bigger screen, they started with 5.3 inch and they just kept going bigger and bigger. So as the phone screen sizes became bigger, it became difficult for all the phone companies. Back then it was mostly Samsung to make a phone which would fit in the hands of an average customer, and you know, you still have a bigger screen. So obviously the only solution was to shrink the bezel. So the race to shrink the bezel started from 2011. That was like the turning point, and since then Samsung and then others followed Samsung, and everybody started shrinking bezel. But it's only in the last few years the craze for eliminating the bezel has really you know, taken on. And for a while it made sense, you know, you had phones with smaller bezel, which meant that you could fit a bigger screen in the same size body. So you could get like a Samsung S6 which had a bigger screen than S5, but it was physically, you know, the same size or smaller than S5. So that was great. But I think now we have gone overboard, and now from a practical point of view, we have reached a state where it's no longer beneficial to keep shrinking bezels. I was never a fan of the notch which Apple used, and also I don't like what Samsung has done with the punch hole. So what OnePlus has done is that they have got rid of everything, and they have this motorized camera. Now here is my question. Would you mind having a small bezel on the top and in the bottom so that you can put like a stereo speaker and you can have your camera, and you don't need a motorized, you know, mechanical setup with that small bezel on top and bottom, and tiny bezel on the sides so that you don't have a curved display? You have a flat screen, there is no distortion. Also, your hands can, you know, rest, and you can hold the phone without touching the screen and, you know, having the ghost touches. Wouldn't that be better? I think most of the companies went with curved display because they mimicked Samsung, and Samsung went with curved display because they had the technology. It was almost like they had a technology and they didn't know what to do with it, so they started putting it on, you know, and they were just like throwing things and seeing if something sticks on the wall. So they came out with this original phone which had one side which was curved, and then finally with Samsung Galaxy S8 they had a design which was much more symmetrical. Now I agree that in promotional photos and videos it does look very cool, but when you actually use it, I don't see any advantage. I have been using a Galaxy S8 phone for a couple of years now, and even after using it for 2 years, I'm still not used to the curved display, and I actually find it irritating. I think The reason we got a curved screen on Samsung phone was because Samsung had a technology, they had this curved OLED screen and they wanted to show it off, and so they just rammed it down the throat of the customers. And they did an excellent job with marketing. The pictures, the promotional photos and videos looked so cool that, you know, that people got scammed into buying this. Also, there are problems with curved screen, right? For example, it's more fragile. If you drop it, since the edges are also screen, it's very easy to crack the screen. And if you crack the screen, then the repair costs are too heavy. On top of that, the curved screen makes it very difficult to put screen protector. And if you do manage to put screen protector, then there is this challenge of finding a case which will go with the screen protector. So you have so many problems. So the argument I'm trying to make here is that this is something which is good for the company. They can come up with a cool technology which really doesn't offer any tangible benefits to the customers, but they are able to show it off in their promotional materials, like the photos and videos, it looks cool, and then they are able to charge more money for these products. And we as customers, we should, you know, take a step back and think about it. Are we paying money for something which is useful, or is it just, you know, gimmick and, you know, we are getting scammed? So that's the question that I'm trying to raise here. So now here we stand with OnePlus 7 Pro. Has a no bezel screen, which unfortunately has introduced distortion because of the curved nature of the screen. And also, when you will hold the phone, we will see how the palm rejection is, but even Samsung hasn't really nailed it. It's always a problem. You are always better off if there is a bezel so that you can hold the phone without touching the screen. Anytime you have all screen display and there is nothing, no physical area for you to hold the phone, even with the perfect palm rejection, it will still create problem. So long story short, it's a mixed bag. I like that OnePlus 7 is pushing the envelope and it's going to put more pressure on flagship phone makers like Samsung and Apple to step up their game. And since now it is available on T-Mobile, that's a good thing. You know, you don't have to just buy directly from them. You can walk into a store and buy a phone. That's good. So those are all positives. I just wish that OnePlus, had come with a model where they had taken some of the goodness from OnePlus 7 Pro and merged it with the OnePlus 7. So my dream OnePlus 7 phone would be a phone which has a flat screen, minimal bezels on top and bottom are fine. I don't want a pop-out front-facing selfie camera. I don't want that. Put the camera in the traditional place. Have a little, bezel on the top and give me a 90 Hertz OLED panel. That would be awesome. So let's see, maybe that would be OnePlus 7T. So that's it, guys. Those are my thoughts on the phone. Let me know what you think about this phone. What do you think about the pop-up camera? What do you think about the curved screen? What do you think about the 90 Hertz OLED panel? Share your thoughts in the comment section below, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.